60 Minutes did a rare good job here covering the issue of money in politics. They're going to interview a Republican congressman named David Jolly, who's really blowing the whistle on just how bad it is. Let's watch.
Florida Republican David Jolly won a special election to Congress in March 2014. Facing a re-election bid that November, he was happy to get a lesson in fundraising from a member of his party's leadership. But he was surprised by what he learned.
We sat behind closed doors at one of the party headquarters back rooms in front of a whiteboard where the equation was drawn out. You have 6 months until the election. Break that down to having to raise $2 million in the next 6 months, and your job, new member of Congress, is to raise $18,000 a day. Your first responsibility is to make sure you hit $18,000 a day.
Your first responsibility, as a congressman?
As a sitting member of Congress.
How are you supposed to raise $18,000 a day?
Simply by calling people, cold calling a list that fundraisers put in front of you. You're presented with their biography, so please call John. He's married to Sally. His daughter Emma just graduated from high school. They gave $18,000 last year to different candidates. They can give you $1,000 too if you ask them to. And they put you on the phone, and it's a script.
There are actually scripts for calls. And we got our hands on one distributed by the National Republican Congressional Committee to help GOP members invite donors to attend their annual fundraising dinner in March.
The House schedule is actually arranged in some ways around fundraising.
You're telling me the whole schedule of how work gets done is scheduled around fundraising?
That's right. You never see a committee working through lunch because those are your fundraising times. And then in between afternoon votes and evening votes, that's when you can see Democrats walking down this street, Republicans walking down that street, to spend time on the phone making phone calls.
By law, members of Congress cannot make fundraising calls from their offices. So both parties have set up call centers just a few blocks away. This is where the Republicans have theirs.
So can I go in there?
I don't think they would let either one of us in here at this point. Remember, I stopped paying my dues.
What Jolly means is that in addition to raising money for their own campaigns, members are supposed to raise thousands of dollars for their parties. That's their dues. If Republican members don't pay up, they can't use the party's call suites. No photos exist of the inside of either the Democratic or Republican centers. But with the help of a staffer, we were able to get into the Republican Center with a hidden camera. About a dozen tiny offices equipped with a phone and computer line a corridor. This is where members of Congress sit behind closed doors and plow through lists of donors, dialing for dollars. Outside in the main hallway is a big board where the amount each member has raised for the party is posted for all to see and compare.
It is a cult-like boiler room on Capitol Hill where sitting members of Congress, frankly, I believe, are compromising the dignity of the office they hold by sitting in these sweatshop phone booths calling people, asking them for money. And their only goal is to get $500 or $1,000 or $2,000 out of the person on the other end of the line. It's shameful.
Let's take this one step further, too. How do you excel in the system that's been set up? Quite literally by selling out the most and selling out the best. So the person who calls the most people, makes the most connections with the donors, and delivers most on the promises made to those donors, those are the people who are gonna advance and climb that career ladder. So, you know, sometimes you see somebody who's a congressman, they're a fantastic fundraiser, and then next thing you know, they win a Senate seat. And then over time, maybe you have that person run for president. And if you've honed those skills and you've sharpened those skills of talking to moneyed interests, massaging them right, getting money out of them, and then when you're in power delivering on those promises, well, you got a bright future in politics. But think about how backwards that system is. Because the entire time now, where are the concerns of the American people? Where are the concerns of the public? Where are the concerns for, you know, some congressman, some senator sitting down with a staffer, and they go over in detail the opinions of the people that are in their state and the policies that they want, and then they turn around and try to push for them to actually get legislation and get bills passed that are right in line with what your people are asking for. They don't do that. That's not even, that never enters their mind. And they spend most of the time, every day they're working, raising money. This is why you see that Congress has, between now it's a 4% approval rating and like a 20% approval rating. It just goes back and forth in that realm. How can that possibly be? Even just after we elect them. If you go back a month later and you say, okay, what's the favorability rating of Congress? 12%, 9%. You guys just fucking voted for them. What do you mean? You just picked them and now you're saying I hate them. Well, why? Because every single time we're picking from the lesser of two evils, and you know that no matter what, even if it's somebody who you like, their personality or whatever, you know that they're cutting backroom deals, you know that they're spending most of the time fundraising like they just described right there, you know that within the structure of this system, the way to excel and the way to succeed is to raise the most money, sell out the most to private donors, and deliver on those promises the most. So this is why there was that Princeton study that found that the American people, so middle class people, poor people, they get what they want in terms of policy. Never. It just doesn't come into consideration what we want. Whereas the moneyed interests, the donor class, the billionaires, the corporations, they get what they want almost every time. So that's the way the system works. And I have to say here, man, far be it from me to ever pick a Republican and vote Republican, but if I had the opportunity, I would vote for David Jolly. I would. Honestly, it might be the case, even if he disagrees with me on everything else, I think I'd vote for him. Why? Because this is the one issue that affects all other issues. So if you get the money out of the system, and he might not know this part, but if you get the money out of the system, you know what happens to the country? Giant leftward turn. Why? Because again, you look at the opinion polls. 80% of the American people want to raise the minimum wage. 90% want a universal background check for gun purchases. 60% want to raise taxes on the rich. 60% want to never cut Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid under any circumstance. Only 17% still want to be in Afghanistan. So if we got the private money out of the system and we made it so the donors don't call the shots anymore and the people call the shots, we're a social democratic country. Like that. So now again, he might not realize that, but he's right on this policy from a principled perspective that, hey, even if the country doesn't agree with me, then it's still the right thing to do in terms of giving them the choice to determine their own future here. And he proposed a bill called the Stop Act, by the way, which makes it illegal for any elected official to raise money. Now, again, he might not understand that that's not the end-all be-all, because we already have a Supreme Court that is saying now that money in politics is a right. Like, it's equal to speech, therefore it is a right. It's a preposterous argument, but that's how they've interpreted the Constitution. So if you pass a law, well, the Constitution overrides laws. So you're still probably going to be able to fundraise, even if you pass a law that says, you know, congressmen or politicians can't fundraise. But again, I support an all-the-above strategy, so am I in favor of this passing? Fuck yeah, I am. I'm just saying it might not be very effectual because of the way the system works and the Constitution overrides laws. So what you really need to do is get a constitutional amendment to get money out of politics, and that's what Wolfpack is attempting to do. And it's the one thing that liberals and conservatives totally agree on. Depending on what poll you look at, it's 80% or higher of the American people say, yeah, let's get this money out of the system because it has a massive corrupting influence. And just final thing I'll say here is, you heard what he said. The goal was to raise $18,000 per day. How are you going to do that? Are you going to do that by calling Grandma Betty in Washington State and saying, hey, do you have $4.72 you can lend me? No. You're only going to call the big money donors. They give you lists. Hey, this person gave $15,000 last year, this candidate and that candidate. You're only going to call rich people. You're only going to call billionaires, millionaires, you know, probably corporations. You're only going to call people who can give you the amount of money that you're trying to raise. If it's $18,000 in a day, you're not going to raise it $7 at a time or $27 at a time like Bernie Sanders does. And Hillary Clinton was bragging about excelling in this system. Oh, God. It's painful to think about, but she was lecturing Bernie Sanders. I raise money for the down ticket Democrats too. So you're so good at selling out and raising all this money that you get a lot for yourself, and then while you're at it, you're like, sure, here's some Wall Street money for this Democrat and that Democrat. And then you pretend like it's a good thing, like we should all fucking applaud you for selling out better than anybody else. No, that just proves our worst suspicions about you, that you're the ultimate insider. And you're more willing than anybody else to cut these backroom deals and do the bidding of your donors. That's the fucking problem right there.